Hey, Jacca from RouteNote here. Today we're going to walk through making an 808 bass synth. 808 synths are a fantastic resource to use in your productions, and they can span genres. And the best bit, they're super easy to make. Today we're going to make one in FL Studio in just a few minutes, and it's going to sound great.
First, open up Sytrus. We don't want this preloaded nonsense, so come up here and set it to default. Let's immediately bring the pitch down here, and in your first oscillator, bring this down to 1. This is giving us a really subby sine wave, like this. Now we want to get the hard, grimy grit of a lot of the 808 basses that you hear. So we're going to pull down the output dial for oscillator 1 and bring up the filter dial for oscillator 1. And don't be a doofus, bring up the output dial too. Now we can actually hear it. We need to head into filter 1 and turn the wave shaper on. And you hear the power from this step. It's absolutely filthy. Now, we can play with the tension here to your taste. Making it tight will give it a serious punch in the gut. Or you can bring it down if the bass is scaring you. We want our 808 bass to shake the skull out of your headphones. Come back into oscillator 1 and head to your volume envelope. Don't be a fool, activate it here. What you do now is up to you and what sound you're after. A classic fat 808 sound can be made by pulling the attack back tightly. We're going to make the sustain and release have a little smooch by pulling it down for one long release. Play with the depth of your fall depending on how long you want the sound to stick around and where you want it to drop off. I'm adding another point here because it's losing its impact too quickly. We want a big heavy punch, like Tyson, not a quick Jackie Chan jab. Tweak it to your liking and to your purpose. I am not the messiah, you can go your own way. Now we're sounding like a nice 808 bass. There's a lot more you can do to tweak it, depending on how freaky you want to get with it. Lift the tension here to give yourself a really dirty Mr. Roizo sounding synth. Bring it down to create a more subtle spacey noise. The shape is going to totally redesign the texture of your sound. Choose your laser. Skew can take the depth out of it for more of an immediate hit of sort of bright sound. And again, the sine shaper is going to reinvent your sound, so find what works for you. This is the noise slider. You get a sticker if you can work out what that's doing. Now, let's finish by bringing in a kick hit into our synth that pumps behind each note of our 808. We want to head to oscillator 2 and the pitch tab for this. Hopefully you remember how not to be a dingus. That's right, enable the envelope. Now we want a really quick wave here, so bring back the attack right to the start and have a rapid release. Now, I'm the dingus here because I haven't raised my output dial to hear the effect. Now you hear it? Yeah. It's a kick like a donkey in heat. Here it is isolated so you can hear the effect. Tweak it to your liking again. How hard do you want the hit? How long do you want to stick around? All these sorts of things help you shape your own 808 and not just a copy. Now, we can change the pitch envelope with this dial here to, you guessed it, change the pitch. Raising it makes a more formed sound, obviously it's higher, or you can bring it all the way down for some sub-destroying low end. If you're looking to massage some spines through the floor with a rig, I mean, just listen to that, it's silly. But it's pretty cool. It's really muddy, so we're going to bring ours back up a bit, but keeping it fairly low for this big filthy bass sound. There you have it. Make some of the dirtiest beats known to man and share it with us at RouteNote. Next time we'll be taking a look at how to mix your new 808 bass synth to maximize its power and bring it into the mix with style. Until then, subscribe for more, give it a like if this helps you out, and a comment is always nice. See you next time.